Good morning, everyone, and happy Monday. Welcome to winter here in Southern California. It's chilly out here today, I'm telling you guys. We are not used to this cold weather. It's only 48 degrees, which I know a lot of you think that's a heat wave where you live, but for us, it is cold. We don't often have days under 48. No sound?
I'm not hearing you.
Okay.
Is everyone else hearing you?
Can you guys let me know if you can hear me? If you can see me, Cliff and Nisha, if you could let us know. Jerry says there's no sound, so hopefully I'm not getting any no sound comments just yet, Jerry. Let's see.
If someone can say yes.
Oh, sound is good. Nisha's hearing it, she says.
Okay. Maybe it's on mine.
Good. So maybe it's on Jerry's end. But anyway, I hope you guys are having a great start to your week, and thank you so much for all of your feedback. As I mentioned, we're under like a winter storm watch here. We had a lot of rain over the weekend, which was super great. The garden is just popping with green. The lawn is actually greening up, which is crazy. It was brown all summer long, so pretty excited about that. But you can see I've got my warm coat on. I actually had to dig in the garage today and find my UGG boots. Haven't seen those in a couple of years because I really want to be outside today. It's so nice to get some fresh, clean air. So today's live stream is going to be fun. We're going to talk about tips to beat the winter blues, because I know for Jerry and I, whenever the darkness sets in, like when the time changes and it gets dark at like 4:45 this time of the year, we always kind of struggle with feeling a little bit down in the evenings because we love to be outside and we're like, oh my gosh, it's like the evening now, it's dark, it just makes us sleepy. So beating the winter blues is I thought would be a really good topic for today. I think a lot of people really struggle with that in the wintertime, especially those of you that are, you know, under snow and cold and can't get outside to garden. Did a little poll here at the beginning of the live stream, and I just asked the question at the top. If you haven't answered yet, go in and answer it. The question was, do you ever experience the winter blues? We'll talk more about what that is in just a moment. And so far, 71% of you have said that you have experienced that. So I think a really appropriate topic for today. But before we dig in, let's say hello to those of you here on the live stream. Thank you so much for joining me on this winter Monday. Tina, yeah, I go to sleep early. I hear ya. We actually get really sleepy usually about 7 o'clock. So we've been trying to take Mac out for a walk. But if we go to bed too early, then we're awake like at 2 a.m. So we try and stay up to like 9 or 10 because we normally get up early anyway, but we don't want to get up too early. Okay, so I hear you on that one. Dr. Cack Food, I think. Hi, happy New Year 2023 to everyone. Great, so glad that you're here. Thanks for joining us. Kaylee, great to have you here. Cliff and Nisha is back, okay? Nisha's been gone for a couple of weeks. Had a fantastic trip to South Africa, and she said it was in the 90s and 95% humidity. So I bet it's a big adjustment coming back to the winter, but glad to have you back. We really missed you, and I hope you had a fantastic trip. I can't wait to see more of your pictures. Okay, so welcome again to the live stream. We're here every Monday at noon Pacific time, and I'm in the chat about a quarter till noon. Anisha and Cliff are here at 11:30, and today we're gonna have some fun. Okay, so talking about the winter blues. Now, it might seem strange to have some fun talking about winter blues, but I think one of the biggest things you can do is talk about it, right? And that actually isn't one of my tips, but I'm actually going to throw in a bonus tip up front, and that is don't go at it alone. I think a lot of us, when the weather gets cold and it gets dark, we just kind of start feeling a little bit listless, a little bit lethargic. I know I do. There's less hours of sunlight, so we may not be getting outside and getting our vitamin D. We're not getting our gardening fix. And it just is kind of sort of a sad feeling. It's not a full-on depression. If it's a full-on depression, you definitely need to go and seek help. But just kind of a feeling of maybe lethargy, feeling down, not feeling as peppy and excited as perhaps you normally would. So it's just kind of a normal type of kind of blue, maybe sad feeling. So definitely, again, if it's something that persists and if it's a serious depression, definitely go and get some help. But the first tip, this isn't even actually on my list, but the first tip that I want to share with you guys is just talk about it, right? Don't go at it alone. Talk about it. Get in a group of people, maybe here on the live stream, maybe you're in another gardening group on Facebook or Instagram, and just get it out there. Like, is anyone else struggling with that? And I'm the first to raise my hand and say I do not like this time of the year when it's dark in the evening. So We're already counting down to December 21st, when that's the shortest day of the year and the days get longer. So the biggest thing is don't go at it alone. Find yourself a garden buddy, maybe your significant other, maybe some friends, maybe the group here, and just talk about it and find some people to share the time and share the companionship with. So big number one is don't go at it alone. I think that's probably the biggest thing I could say is find a buddy. If you don't have a buddy, make a buddy and find a friend that you can really share some time with and share some of the gardening, or the not the gardening blues, the winter blues feelings with. Because for those of you that are like under snow, I shared on my video, I forget which video it was, but how it was Terry said that the garden was closed down already for 2 months, and it's 6 more months until they're going to be able to get outside. So I really feel for you there. It'd be really a tough spot to be, but I know a lot of you are in that situation where it's cold, it's snowing, it's maybe below zero for months on end, and you can't get outdoors to garden. So definitely find someone that you can share that with. And we're here for you on Mondays and with our videos during the week, where you can comment and we can all share the feelings of winter blues that we might have together. So first quick little tip is that don't go at it alone. So I want to hear from you all in the chat how things are going for you, if you felt that way at all this week, and then we'll dig into our next tip here. Okay, so camera guy is saying we're getting back to our mandatory walks. Either in the evenings or after we're finished with our work day, we get outside and take Mac out for a walk. We enjoy it, he enjoys it. And even if you live where it's cold, maybe not like below zero, but I think last night we took him out and it was in the 40s, and we just bundled up like this and just got out there and walked, and we warmed up as we walked. Okay, Terry says, some cities have indoor garden displays this time of the year at their botanical gardens. That may be helpful to some people. Yeah, that's a great suggestion, is to get out there and find something green to look at. Maybe you do have an indoor area where you can go. I know a lot of people, I grew up in Colorado, and a lot of people used to walk around the mall, around all the stores and around the mall, to get their exercise and to get outside, or not outside, but to get out of their house and to have a little bit of break from being indoors in the cold. So if you can't get outside because it's too cold, maybe there's an area like that, either an indoor type of garden setting or an indoor mall where you could go and get some exercise. Jack, hi, how are you? It's great to have you on the chat today. And Jack's saying it gets dark here by 4:45 and no city lights. So yeah, if you live somewhere like where Jack lives, he lives out of the city a little bit, there's no lights around, there's no light pollution, you might get some really good viewing of the stars. But yeah, that is super, super early. So a good opportunity to, just get together with some friends, or, you know, have some friends over, share a beverage, and just have someone to share the companionship with. And Tina says, I take an early morning walk. Yeah, I think there's something about that, of just getting out and getting some exercise if you're able to, that really just releases those endorphins and helps get the body moving and helps you feel really good. So, okay, digging back into what I wanted to share for today as far as tips, is the first one is bring in some color and light as much as you can, okay? Whether it's, you know, opening up your curtains so you get more light into your room, into your living room, or wherever you might be spending your days, adding in color. Maybe it's like some bright colored pillows. Maybe it's just, you know, planting something right outside your window so that you can see it. Just add some color and light, because color is very, very therapeutic. There's just something about it. I know for me, when I've got the bright pops of color, like I have right back there, the little bright smart pots, it really just lifts my spirits. So maybe you want to put a little bright something next to your kitchen sink that you can grow something in. So there's just something about seeing that color that just really, really lifts your spirits. One thing that I know my daughter is really into this is succulents. There's so many bright colored succulents that don't take a lot of care that you can pop around your house, even if they're like fake plants, okay? I'll admit I have a couple of fake succulents in my living room, all right? I'm not ashamed to admit that. I mean, they're so easy to grow, but I have so much to water, like in the indoor garden and outside. I do put a couple little bright pops of color around my house around, like on my mantle and things like that, that are fake succulents, all right? But real ones are super easy to grow, and they come in so many different bright colors. So that's kind of a fun, easy to take care of thing to do in the wintertime, is just add those bright pops of color around your house. And even if you have to, like, maybe move some furniture around a little bit, like in front of a window where you can maybe open that up so you can open the curtains and let some light in, maybe it's worth it to do that in the wintertime, just to help lift your spirits, because color and light does amazing things to just make you feel a lot better. Let me hear in the chat if any of you have any ideas for bringing in some color and some light into your house to lift those winter blues and kind of chase them away. Because if we all just are here up front saying, this is a real thing, right? We all are dealing with this. And we plan some things into our day, into our week, to help lift our spirits and actually make a conscious choice to do that, then more likely than not, we're all going to feel a whole lot better for it. Okay, back in the chat, let's see what's going on here. Terry, I am so glad that you said that. I'm glad I'm not the only one. Terry said, I did that with a few fake succulents too while waiting for my seeds to grow. Yeah, absolutely. No shame in that, right? I mean, let's just all get real here. So Terry, thank you so much. I'm glad that you were brave enough to admit that. Okay, Sister Marcel, it's great to have you here. And Sister Marcel says, I'm trying to motivate myself to organize my potting area in the basement to prep for seed starting. So that's a great thing to do as well, Sister Marcel, is to get involved in a project. And I think we're gonna talk about that a little bit later in the live stream. So we'll hold on to that just a moment. Okay, Stephanie's saying, I agree, light, opening the windows and blinds and standing in the sun for just a minute, it's psychological. Absolutely, Stephanie, I couldn't agree with you more. Now, at our house here, in the wintertime, it's kind of an interesting situation because the backyard is almost completely shaded by the house in the wintertime. So it's literally about 10 degrees colder out back than it is out front. So sometimes Jerry and I, just to get some warmth and some light, we'll go and stand out front because it feels like a different season out there. Jerry, thank you so much for making this a cozy little area for me today. He's got a fire going. I actually have a heater next to me. So he's really taking good care of me on the live stream today. But yeah, do what you can to get outside, get some light, and just soak up that vitamin D. It does amazing things for your spirit. Okay, second tip here to help beat the winter blues away, and for me, this is the biggest thing of all, is to add some plants indoors. Now, we talked about succulents, but of course, you all know that I am really big on indoor gardening. We are absolutely loving the indoor garden. Hopefully you caught our video on how to create some really super easy meals from microgreens. And go back and watch my indoor garden series, because you'll see my whole indoor garden there, a whole shelf in my corner full of green and full of color. So if you haven't done that yet, I want to encourage you, highly encourage you, to add a few very simple vegetables that you can grow inside. My favorite, of course, the easiest of all to start with is microgreens. You gotta grow microgreens, and watch the video on three different ways that we enjoy eating microgreens for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Literally takes like 5 minutes to prepare. So you gotta add some indoor veggies. And talking about color, the little 1 gallon smart pots are three different colors. The blue, here's a purple, herbs. So add some microgreens, add some herbs inside. This is basil growing inside. Pretty chilly to grow it outside right now, but you can definitely grow some of this indoors. And then the orange one, I don't have an orange one out here, but you gotta grow your salad greens as well. And we pick from these all the time. You guys heard my story last week about how we had friends over, had burgers, and they all just picked some lettuce from the little 1 gallon smart pots to put on their burger. So you gotta grow some plants indoors. It's so fun, and it's a guaranteed way to beat the winter blues. There's something about too, just having something to nurture and care for. Not only does it give you kind of a project to do in the wintertime, be a really fun thing to do with your kids. You know, when they get home from school, or if you're homeschooling, they can care for the plants. You can do a whole little class on how to grow microgreens and herbs. And you know what? When kids plant the seeds themselves, they're a lot more likely to eat the veggies. Now, you might have seen on my Instagram today that my tiny Tim tomato growing inside is actually getting tomatoes. So very excited about that. Go over and check out my Instagram stories. But it's also fun to grow tomatoes inside. Now, this one is not the one getting tomatoes yet, but this one is growing inside and will be repotted into a 5-gallon smart pot so it has more room to grow. But super fun to add some plants inside, whether it's a pot of microgreens or herbs by your kitchen window, or a whole grow light little corner setup like I have. So really great way to kind of beat the winter blues, plus the added benefit, of course, of having some healthy food to eat just steps away from your kitchen when you may not be able to eat outside or grow it outside. So kind of helps in, during the bridge the gap there during those winter months when you can't grow outside. You're going to absolutely love it. So I want to hear from you in the chat if anyone is growing an indoor garden, what you're growing, what you're eating from it, and how it's going for you. Okay, Anne, thank you so much. Anne, love the microgreens video. Really glad you enjoyed that. It's really easy to incorporate the healthy microgreens into just about every meal. Terry has a question about microgreens. My microgreens don't seem to come back after I cut them. I have to keep adding more seeds. Am I doing something wrong? Terry, you're absolutely not doing anything wrong. What usually happens for me is, I can usually get like one really good cut from my microgreens, and I usually just snip a little bit at a time, whatever I'm using in that particular meal. And then once my whole thing is harvested, or, you know, like here I only harvested a little bit on the front, it will come back not near as heavy as the first time. And usually what I'm doing weekly when I water, this needs water today, is I am adding a little bit of fertilizer to the water to help them re-sprout and regrow. So I use the Vermistera Vitality and the Good Dirt. I put it in the bottom of the tray, and then it'll get like, you know, pretty, not near as big of a harvest the second time around. And then what I do is just pick out the little stems and replant the seeds. So I'm usually planting a new pot of microgreens maybe once a week. I think I had a couple of questions on that from the video, and that way we have a pretty continual supply of microgreens growing. And today I'm actually, after this, of course, we're gonna eat something warm, right? I've got some chicken tortilla soup, just like we showed on our video last week. It's one of my favorite kinds of soup. And we're gonna be sprinkling some microgreens on top of that. So it's just super easy to incorporate that healthy food into your meals when you're eating or growing it inside. Okay, All to Grow Urban Gardening, welcome. So glad that you're here today. And I'm growing, the question here is, I'm growing my first fall winter garden, or more of a common, I guess. It's definitely helped to ward the off season blues. I am so glad to hear that. And I'm glad that that's been encouragement to you. It really, really does help. So that's awesome to hear that. Anything that you can do to help kind of stave that off is really all that much better. And Tina asks, Kelly Kim, do you have a link to the longer grow lights that you use? Yes, all the links should be in the video description. And I try and go through and update the grow light links because they do kind of change things around on Amazon. And I'll check after this if that link is still good. But check the video description for any supplies that I use in any of my videos. And usually it's an Amazon link where you can pick them up. And Broke Farmer says, facts, kids will eat what they put work into. And I absolutely love that because they will. They're invested in it that way. They take ownership of it, and they're going to be excited to eat it. And before I forget, you guys, if you want to grow microgreens, grab the microgreen seed collection. You don't ever have to wonder about what to grow. All my seed collections are specially curated by season and by vegetable to make things easy for you to get started. So you can grab these over at calikimgardenandhome.com, and the indoor garden seed collection are also the two most popular ones this time of the year, so you can grow indoors. And today's the last day of the 20% off sale with the code GROWFOOD. And the cool thing about this sale is you get a free seed collection with your order. This is a Bring on the Pollinators Cool Season flower collection. There's 6 varieties in here. So head over, grab your seeds today. And by the way, the 14th, which I think is Wednesday, is actually the last day for guaranteed delivery. This is from USPS, guaranteed delivery by Christmas. So if you want to get any garden kits or gifts for any of your friends, make sure you grab those today so we can get them packed up. Grab them with the sale, the 20% off. We can get them packed up, shipped out, and sent off for gifts. And my books, if you want to purchase the signed copies, make sure that you send me an email on the person you'd like me to address the book to. And also, if you want me to include a special note, I'm happy to do that as well. So grab those over at CallieKimGardenHome.com. Okay, so let's see what we have going on in the chat here. We'll take one more question before we move on. And let's see here. The smell of basil, it's so yummy. Yeah, I absolutely love that too. Okay, I love this. V says, Kim, I still feel like a kid when I see the sprouts. There's just something about that, right? When you see them kind of bust through the soil, and these arugula ones, I think germinated in just a couple of days. So it's so easy to get them to grow. And these are particularly great for kids because they germinate very, very quickly. Okay, tip number three, and we kind of already have alluded to this, but tip number three to beat the winter blues away is to eat healthy and get moving, okay? It's super, super easy, myself included, to just sit in front of the TV and eat whatever you can get your hands on in the evening, all right? Let's just get it out there and be honest. It's very tempting, very easy to do in the evening when we have more downtime than we would in the summer. But resist the urge to do that. Fill your house with healthy food, like all the foods we just talked about, healthy snacks. I actually have been really into deviled eggs, and I think I'm going to sprinkle some of my microgreens on top today. But I just got done making them right before the live stream, is making up a whole bunch of deviled eggs with a little bit of mayo, some mustard, a lot of pickles, salt and pepper, and sprinkling it with a little bit of smoked paprika. So good, a healthy snack. I love the dark chocolate peanut butter cups. They're so good. If you make them with that 75% dark chocolate and like an almond butter, it's a lot better than downing a bowl of ice cream. So just keep healthy stuff around. Incorporate your indoor garden, grocery store, however you can, and the meals that we showed you how to make on last week's video, and just stay healthy and then get out there and get moving. It's going to do a lot for your spirits if you're eating well and you're just moving as much as you can, and getting some sunshine or going to the indoor mall and walking around as much as you can, like we talked about. But I think the biggest thing is just to keep some healthy food on hand. So you know, whatever you have to do that, look up some healthy recipes and just keep it around the house. I just saw we got a super chat. That's awesome. I didn't even see that fly by. I must have been looking down here. Stephanie, oh my gosh, that is so kind of you. Thank you so much. Stephanie just made a $19.99 super chat. Really appreciate that, Stephanie. You have been a huge supporter of ours for a long time, and we really appreciate that. So thank you so much for that super chat. Okay, one thing I was gonna say too is I have been looking up lately some workouts on YouTube. So I'm not one that loves to go to the gym. I don't like going to the gym, but I will work out at home, and we walk and we hike a lot. But I've been looking up like some 20-minute workouts that I get up early in the morning and do. So I don't like to work out for 30 or 40 minutes, but 20 minutes is just right for me. It's just the right amount of time. So look some up on YouTube that you can do yourself at home, and just make sure that you get moving no matter how cold it is outside. There's so many resources out there. So really no reason why you can't do that from the comfort of your living room, right? You don't have to spend money to belong to a gym unless that's what you really enjoy. But I think the cool thing about keeping moving is that it just gets those endorphins rolling in your body, besides, of course, being good for you and keeping you in shape. It just releases those endorphins, and you just feel better and feel happier that you're doing something good for yourself. Okay, love growing alfalfa sprouts each week. Family participated. This is from Janaki. Sorry if I didn't say your name correctly. But yeah, really fun to get your family in there. And thank you so much for sharing that. And I'm so glad that you're doing that. Sprouts are super easy to grow too. You can also use the microgreen seed collection to grow sprouts. Sprouts are just grown in with water rather than in soil. So really easy green thing to grow in your kitchen as well during this winter. Okay, let's see what other questions we have on here. Tina's saying she works out at home too. So glad to hear that. That's awesome. Brett, how are you, Brett? Oh my gosh, hello from Canada. One of my daughter's friends. Great to have you on here today. And I bet you're cold up there. So we'll be sending you some warmth here from Southern California. And Patricia is saying, I'm going to start an indoor garden now because I was too sick the last several weeks. I need some garden therapy. So Patricia, great to hear that. And you're going to get one going there. And I'm super glad that you are feeling better. Okay. Tip number four here for helping beat the winter blues is give yourself a task to accomplish, right? Give yourself a task to accomplish. And I think we all need a sense of purpose, a sense of satisfaction, a sense of feeling good about doing something rather than just, you know, wasting our day away. So figure out a task that you can easily do and that's attainable and achievable, and make it your goal to accomplish that task. So whether it's having an indoor garden, you do not have to have a big, huge corner of your house like I do. Just have a couple of pots. Make it a goal, keep it simple, make it something that you can easily accomplish. Maybe you want to organize your seed bin. I forgot who it was that said they were going to be organizing their seed starting area so they were ready for spring. So we all know how busy it gets when spring starts. We're starting our seeds, we have so much to do. And now's the time to just set aside a little bit of time each day. Doesn't have to be hours and hours. Maybe it's 15 or 20 minutes. Maybe it's 30 minutes to accomplish a task. Now, it feels good to really be in a routine. And I think that's one of the things about wintertime is trying to develop a routine to either care for your plants or accomplish a task for the day, maybe after you've gotten home from work. And just to really feel good about that. There's so many different things you can do. You can, like I mentioned, organizing your seeds. Maybe you can build something that you want to maybe put in your garden in the springtime. Hey, you could even build a raised bed inside, right? If you're going to really go for it, or if it's warm enough to get outside, build your raised beds right now outdoors. That way it's not so crazy busy in the springtime when you're ready to get going. Maybe you need to go around and kind of repair your tools or clean the rust off your tools. Maybe you need to actually winterize your garden, maybe clean up your drip irrigation for the season, that type of thing. Grab a friend, and maybe you can come to a friend's garden for one morning and then go to their, or have them come to your garden so you can work together and give yourself a little task to accomplish, right? So it's really important though to balance your hard work with some fun, right? Maybe grab yourself a nice hot cup of coffee like I have right here. A favorite snack. Just do something to balance that hard work and incorporate a friend or a family member whenever you can to really give yourself a sense of purpose. And before you know it, you won't even be remembering that you were feeling the winter blues because you'll be chasing them away with all of these things that you're doing. But I think the most important thing is to plan for it, right? To not just like give into it, but actually make the choice so that you won't be feeling as sad maybe as you were last year, and then to share it with other people. Okay, I'm gonna dig back into the chat here, see what's going on. I see a lot of things going by, and I think there's lots of great ideas here. Edward is saying that this past summer, and Jerry is out here filming a reel for his Instagram. So make sure that you follow him at Kelly Camera Guy over on Instagram, and you're gonna see the reel that he's filming right here live on YouTube. Don't you guys love his Instagram? I absolutely love it. All kinds of fun behind the scenes stuff. So if you don't follow him, make sure that you do. And I promise you, you won't regret it. Okay, Edward was saying, this past summer, my corn was delicious, sweet and tender, juicy. And I really wanted to, I froze some of it. Okay, sorry, I missed your comment there, or it scrolled by. So now's a great time, way to go, Edward. Now's a great time to pull out some of those garden fresh veggies that you might have preserved and get that garden fresh goodness going there on your table. Nicole, how are you? My garden is under 3 feet of snow, so no way you can get out there, Nicole, right? So now's a great time to get that indoor garden grocery store going and bring it all inside. Okay, let me scroll down here. Warning, me and you, hello, says if you start with 3 pots after 1 year, you'll have 6 pots. So yeah, the pots tend to multiply, right? And before you know it, you are hooked. And by the way, I saw a lot of you in the pre-chat saying that you're seed addicts. I don't think I know a gardener who's not a seed addict. I think we see all those amazing vegetables. We want to grow one of everything. So I think we all are tempted to buy all the seeds that we possibly can. So really a good time to get those seeds organized. Oh, and before I forget too, we will not be live streaming on December 26th, which is the day after Christmas. We'll be off that day. But we will be live streaming a week after that, which is January 2nd. So we'll just be off 1 week for Christmas this year because Christmas falls on a Sunday. So we don't have to take January 1st off. So hopefully if you've got kids that are home from school during those times, you'll bring them along and watch the live stream with us. And hopefully they can learn and get excited about growing something. Okay, Lou says, I need to clean my tools and reorganize my seeds. Okay, now is a great time to do that because once you get it gets to be spring, we want to be outside. We don't want to be cleaning our tools, right? And I want to welcome Marie back. She's been gone from the live streams for a little bit, so great to see you here, Marie. And who wants to be cleaning their tools in the summertime? And she's saying, such a fun Instagram. Yeah, I'm sure about Jerry's, right? Yeah, really fun Instagram. Okay, everybody wave. Yeah, I hope everybody's waving and hitting that like button and subscribing as well. I really appreciate that. Let me scroll back through here and see if we have any more comments. And Martinez is spring cleaning my room as I listen to you. You know what? That's a really good thing to do during the wintertime too, is go through your closets, clean things out when you can't get outside, and make sure that you just like taken all the extra stuff out and have, you know, make yourself more space. I always tell myself it's okay to have empty shelves because invariably they always get filled up, but it really feels good to go through and purge all those things that maybe you're not too excited to wear, or just maybe things that you have around the house that you don't need. Okay, let's see here. Scrolling down through the chat. And Angela is saying, Angela Walton, great to have you here. I have multiple packets of Cali Kim seeds. Thank you so much, Angela. And I'm planning my spring planting to get through the winter. So that's a great thing to do too, is grab yourself some graph paper and start mapping out your spring garden. Maybe some new things that you would like to grow, some new trellises that you like to make, maybe some new raised beds that you like to make. Get yourself educated. I've got two great gardening books that you can read and plan on how to build raised beds and how to start from seed and all those different kinds of things. So it's a great way to get through the winter. And by the way, you guys, the seed collection seeds are not going to go bad from season to season. They will last you for several years. So now's a good time to stock up with all the sales going on that I have and get your spring garden all like planned out and stock up on seeds. Because a lot of places have good sales this time of the year as well. Nicole says she found a craft project to do while I'm snowed in. It's a wood burning and making plant and herb labels. Wow, that sounds really fun. I bet those are really, really beautiful. Ricardo, here it is. My worms are not happy in their worm bin. Yeah, they're probably absolutely freezing, right? So hopefully they'll make it till spring. Maybe you can find a nice little sunny spot to keep them in. And Connie says, I keep running out of dirt to fill my pots. I use my old dirt, revamp to fill new pots, and then have none for the old pots. Yeah, that's the great thing about, especially when you use good dirt soil, which we use, is you can use it time and time again. It doesn't get compacted and worn out. You just need to add a little bit of fresh mix each time. But look for the sales, maybe at your garden centers, for potting mix this time of the year as well. Okay, let's see here. Any other questions before we sign off for the day? And Marie is saying how busy she is with her job. So it's nice that you have a little time off today that you can join us, and hope you'll get some time off over Christmas so you can join us for another live stream. Okay, let's see here. Cleaned out, so many of you doing different projects. I'm cleaning out, reorganizing your sheds, organize all my drip irrigation and irrigation supplies, plant my older seeds. Yeah, those are definitely good to do as well. End of the road Gordon Flower Farm, emptied a room, cleaned everything out, turned it into a spare room and a seed starting room. Wow, that's a great idea. And all kinds of little projects that we can do here in the winter to chase the winter blues away. So what a fun live stream today. And it just shows like when we all get together, there's so much synergy in a group of people, and we can all encourage each other and grow even through the winter time together. So really appreciate y'all being here. So camera guy.
Yeah. That's my lead in. Yeah, it's a great time. I've been telling everybody all through the chat how great a time this is for all of us just to talk shop and have fun together.
Really fun. So we'll be back next Monday, same time, same place. Then I think the week after that is the week we're off for Christmas. But in the meantime, I want you all to take one of these tips, take it to heart, and go out there and do it. And then next week, hopefully I remember to ask, but next week, come back and share with us how it went. So thanks so much for joining us on today's live stream. Stay warm, everyone. Go out and plant something. All right. Happy Monday. Bye-bye.
Bye.